Welcome to Sad Games. We're playing Tales from the Borderlands, or better known as Tales from that game that was really boring. So
it's the Telltale adventure game from the people that made Walking Dead, the good one, not the terrifying, horrible one with Daryl in it, and
Wolf Among Us, that series we did not that long ago.
Yes.
So
the one that Andrew liked a lot.
Yeah. So I am actually playing because Keith has the MO of playing all these before we actually do recordings.
Yeah. I can't let's play these games blind. I can't take it. I need to just experience it first.
Yeah. So it's fine by me because I don't give a fuck about the story.
Yeah.
So.
But what's going on in here?
Is this loading screen okay?
It's literally dying. It's the end.
Yeah, this is like 20 frames per second.
Surprisingly,
loading
despite...
Okay.
You'll be surprised to see this, but despite the loading screens looking like shit, this game actually runs really smoothly when it's running.
I believe it. That's why I was like, look, now everything looks okay.
Yeah, I know,
it's just
right?
The loading screen was like,
Telltale Games never actually run smoothly. But the guy that we're playing mostly as the guy on the left.
So this one?
We want to go back real quick just to see the guys. So what's going on here is you're going to be playing as both these characters in parallel storylines, cutting back and forth.
Okay.
That guy works for
Hyperion. Oh, that's a good thing to know. My arm's gone. I have a robot arm.
He doesn't have an arm. He also has a cyborg eye. So his deal is that he works for Hyperion, which is that floating H satellite up there.
You need to say this? Isn't this going to be in the game?
It kind of just jumps straight into it. So I'm just giving a little introduction here.
Okay.
Like, he works for basically the evil corporation that Jack runs, Jack. This takes place after Borderlands 2 when Jack's already dead. And that's just the basic there, and she's just someone down on the planet.
Okay.
Which is basic intro.
So let's go to play, and then...
It's just good to know that everyone hates Hyperion, because that comes into play with the story.
Well, I don't, because I don't know them. So we'll figure that out. Jesus Christ. All right. Loading screen. You need to fix that.
The loading screens look terrible in this game. I don't know why.
Can we get a patch? This game series adapts to the choices you make. Oh, fuck. I wasn't prepared for that.
Story is tailored by how you play.
I've never had a game.
I thought it was going to be tailored by loading screens.
Back again to hear another story of immense fortune.
Oh, shit.
Did you skip it?
No.
Oh, look.
I'm putting
turn on those subtitles.
Yeah.
There you go.
Why is this not default for every game ever? I'm so tired of doing that. Okay.
It's like our favoriteest thing.
Well, I have some time.
Yeah, so do we.
The borderlands of Pandora were told to contain mysterious alien treasure troves filled with advanced technology and incredible power. Vaults, the people called them. And to seek one out was to earn you the title of Vault Hunter. At least by me.
Oh, that sounds a lot
it's
like...
It's good, we don't care what you think.
Sounds like fucking Fallout.
His methods could be seen
The difference is that everyone started out in vaults in Fallout.
Oh, this time now all the cool stuff's in a vault.
Yeah, the vaults are where cool shit is, and you want to open them up.
Okay, so not like Fallout, where the vaults are full of boring shit, like people in the fucking Snake Clan.
Because the overbearing and obnoxious loot system of Borderlands is literally the story of Borderlands.
That is sad. That's the part I hated the most about the game.
Yeah.
What does that say about your story?
Obvious rewards.
So I didn't know this because I didn't play Borderlands 2 beforehand, but I guess Jack died.
Those are much better
in that game.
Because
this takes place after, and he's dead.
Stories remember both sides of the tale.
Get it? Both sides of the tale, because we're going to play as two characters with different perspectives.
Okay.
Right after the camera decides to move. There we go.
Okay, it was loading. All right. I was like, that skeleton sure is conspicuous, I guess. Maybe I thought I was supposed to, like, observe the skeleton or something. I was like, am I supposed to do something there?
Mr. Bones will not remember this.
Yeah. Okay, I get it. It's a Borderlands. There's a lot of fucking dead things.
We're set in the moment.
No, not really.
It's framing. This guy likes vests.
It's in the fucking title. It's called Borderlands. Like,
this guy likes vests and tattoos.
Sir? This property junction is really run down. Maybe you should go to a different town. One that isn't run down.
Why are you all alone, buddy?
Oh.
Come on, we can work this out.
Ooh.
Fiona being the name of the girl on the cover.
Is that the best voice actor you can get?
Fiona? What, is there some sort of radiation leak I don't know about?
Way to go, Reese. Alright.
Company man, you. Okay. Wait, you thought it wasn't conspicuous that there was a fucking random person with radiation?
That Raiden was here?
Yeah.
Post-apocalyptic Raiden?
Yeah, what the fuck? Is this really duct tape?
I can't tell.
Also, what? Excuse me? That's not how tape works at all.
I just assume they just stole...
What's happening?
I assume they just stole Lulu's belt.
Okay, then do you mind asking yourself what you're doing?
Thank you. Also, how does this tape work? Shouldn't tape be, like, closer on your body and not, like, an actual, like, shirt?
Maybe it's magical tech tape.
Is that what this is about? Look, Gordas is bad business. If you want a real hot investment, I am on the ground floor of some property on Eid. Okay.
Don't be a smartass.
Or I'll shoot it off, apparently.
I could tell, you smacked me the moment I talked to you.
You gotta be pretty patient to be looking cross-eyed through your fucking mask all day with its single hole in the middle.
Maybe that's just how he was born.
Oh no.
Right.
Maybe he's a Cyclops.
Oh no.
I mean,
new canon for Borderlands, the Cyclops people taking over the world. Pandora will never be the same without its unobtainium.
Well, I'm glad we played as that guy for like a whole 5 seconds.
Yeah.
Let's go play as Unicron.
No, you're still playing as him.
Oh, thought we were playing as a planet.
With a promotion.
He's having him tell
the
story of what's going on.
Career up at Hyperion, so I suppose that makes me one of the bad guys.
By the way, that means that we had a framing device for a framing device just now.
Handsome Jack.
Great.
He was the baddest guy of them all.
That guy did a narration that brought us to this scene, so this guy could do a narration bring us to this scene.
Right?
God.
I mean, you all said that.
Everyone did.
I gotta be honest, I always thought it was sort of cheesy, but hey, here we are.
Which resulted in a company overflowing with assholes.
Animals.
When Handsome Jack died, it somehow got even worse. It took some time to fit in. But
get it? Because that's on the cover of every Borderlands game.
A new haircut?
Oh, I got it. Thanks for pointing that out, Keith. I wouldn't have got it otherwise.
Promotion that was going to change my life. Scratch that. Our lives for the better.
Our lives? Who?
I was a little distracted. It was a big day for us. Luckily, Vaughn was concentrating on the important things.
What's the first thing you're going to buy? I know what Henderson's making. I do his payroll.
That was really loud.
Yeah. Your best friend and really loud person.
So you think you're getting a promotion at this point.
It's not about money, Vaughn. It's about the respect it gets you.
Yeah, you know who talks like that? Poor people that no one likes.
What?
It's nice, you know, but
what?
It's not nicer than a summer home on Eden 7. Get your priorities straight.
Okay, thank you.
Afterward to celebrate. She booked us a table.
He can take your respect and shove it up your ass.
We had to do a lot of awful stuff.
Cyborg ass. Do you have a robot butt?
Sure, I
probably.
Do. Every night it haunts my dreams, but that doesn't matter now. Because you made it. You deserve this, man. And
do
don't
I?
Ever think you don't. And don't ever think about the original
just own it.
Deal we put together.
Hey, we made it, okay? We're in this together. If I'm moving up, we're all moving up. You can be certain of that.
I appreciate it.
Look at Andrew getting chummy with someone for the first time ever.
I know, I like this guy. Stuff. He fucking disrespected me when
you?
I said something about respect.
Does that give you bonus points in your world?
Yeah, that gives me bonus points in my world. When I was trying to be nice, he told me to shove it, and I was like, good, I like this character already.
Oh, right.
You're supposed to put on your Hyperion face.
No, we need some condescending.
That's pretty incredible.
A little too friendly right now. Okay, tell you what. Tilt your head back. Like if you ask me if there's anything up your nose.
How's that?
There you go.
That's
you
fucking
don't respect
horrible.
Me at all. Perfect.
Okay. I thought sneering would be the most disrespectful thing of those options, but I guess
oh
it wasn't.
Oh my god. Well, he dropped that pretty quick.
Mr. Henderson?
Have a seat, Reese. I'll just be a second.
Oh, God, is this guy?
Yeah.
No, I wasn't talking.
Thank God they hired somebody with talent.
Yes, I'm talking to you now.
Yeah, but I don't want
to... Hey, Peter.
Because black is better. Look, don't concern yourself with why, okay, Jerry? Concern yourself with how. And just send the car over when it's ready. Company car.
Oh, that was not the face I was expecting. What the fuck?
So this was supposed to be your new office,
you
but...
You look surprised to see me, Reese, and... If I'm reading the situation right, and I usually am, you're not too happy about it either. This all came together quick, so you might not have been in the loop, but it's at least for me.
Henderson promised me a promotion.
I see. Well, Henderson is out.
So,
you're going to be reporting to me now, Reese.
And I want you to know the promotion hair
that you worked so hard to get. That's still coming to you.
Well, that's a relief.
But this is about more than that, Reese. It's about your future in this company.
What fucking company? What does this company do?
Look, you want to know the reason money why I'm in that chair and you're not?
Because you're an asshole and you have better voice acting talent?
Why the handsome guy always gets the girl, and why every spaceship in the universe is shaped like a cock.
Is it?
It's destiny, Reese.
Oh, and okay, man, good. Really, I figured it was because of that shitty game that came out on the
whose
PS4.
Whose dick is shaped like a TIE fighter?
All destiny ships.
No harm, no foul. Your thoughts are your own.
I mean, have you seen an X-Wing? This is basically an erect penis.
Sometimes
what
men
is
find
that
themselves standing in the way of other men's destiny. You don't want to be that man.
Welp.
Oh, wow. There's the old guy.
I could not have timed that better. That really helps dramatically make my point.
So that's Henderson.
Which is this? This promotion is going to take you out of the way.
PlayStation, stop.
And put you on your own path. And that, my friend.
Why is it doing that?
I am promoting you to Jerry. Why isn't my new car digistructing in my office yet?
Vasquez, it's August.
Oh, August. Cool. Listen, I actually have somebody here with me, so.
Are you buying this vault key or what? Because I.
How did this happen so quick? I thought I'd have more time. Of course, I'm still interested. I. Yes, I'm near a computer. 10 million. Yeah. It's just that's a lot of money to get together on short notice. I mean, I'm not trying to be obstinate, but I need time.
He's being super sneaky about this, right?
Look at Pandora? No. Rotate computer.
Yeah, that was smooth. No one's gonna fall for that. Yeah, you're in the clear.
No, but...
Alright, so hit L1. There you go.
What the fuck is this bullshit?
It's oh, your eye of cheating.
It's
an encrypted file.
Okay. Stop. Download
the
crypt. Fuck yeah.
Yes.
It's good to be a cyborg, man.
I guess so.
With a freaky hand projector.
Yeah, that's the weird part, I think. Oh, okay.
The vault key.
Why are you trying to screw me on this? Just wait.
So he's got some sort of deal down on Pandora with someone involving a vault key.
It's gonna be $10 million. I'm gonna need another hour or two. Okay. Yeah, I'll be there in a bit. Well, then just stay there. It's a tourist shop, right? Buy a mug or something. Sure.
Maybe buy a coffin for that guy out there floating in space. Okay. Like, fuck.
Space is his coffin. His coffin is the eternity.
Well, it's also kind of disturbing because that's gonna be forever there in front of your window now. Like... Whoa, bro.
What were we talking about?
Your mom?
I mean, he's not going to decompose or anything.
So, rudely interrupted.
Something about a vault key.
I think it was something about buying a vault key, right?
Oh, just like that. Buying a vault key, right? You're like a kid sounding out the words.
Okay.
All right. Your promotion.
Yeah.
Henderson was a fool. He didn't know his place.
It was in space, clearly, to be dead.
Humility. But you.
He was born to be free
you,
of life.
That's why I'm going to make you assistant vice janitor.
What?
No. No.
Can't even just make him a full janitor.
Now, Reese, I do whatever I want. Report to Sewage Scout 23. Effective immediately.
What a piece of shit. Well, here's some character motivation.
Humiliate me. I quit.
Careful now, kid. The only way you quit Hyperion is the way Henderson did.
No, that's absolutely not true. You clearly don't understand my cyborg skills.
Can't you just punch him with your crazy cyborg
hand?
That's
what I'm thinking. Like, I can just smack him in the face.
I'll let you know when I need my trash can emptied.
Fuck that guy in his really weirdly large office.
What the hell was that? He can't do this to us. He just did.
No. No, no, this can't be happening.
I'm finished, Bo. I'm finished. You know this place is. There's blood in the water, and everyone can smell it!
Just yell at Randy.
Except that guy.
Not yet, unless you don't quiet down. We just gotta keep it on the down low until we figure...
He's like, you just gotta keep it down. Let's kick it!
Senior Vice Janitor Reese to Sector D451 for trash cleanup. Because that is your job now, to clean up trash with your bare hands.
Sorry, you were saying something, I interrupted you.
I love that.
Well, I'm already early for my job.
Yeah.
I'm really good at this, apparently.
How'd you get there so fast? That's incredible.
Like the opposite of a promotion?
Henderson's dead.
What? Are you sure?
Yeah.
No.
No, the dead body floating in front of the window might have been a prop.
Outside in space.
I mean, they have holograms in the future.
He threw Henderson out of an airlock and demoted Reese to trash man.
Holy crap.
You don't
so
really
does
look
that
concerned.
Mean you're not buying?
She might be a psychopath.
With that hairstyle, maybe.
Well, just trying to lighten the mood. And I didn't bring my wallet, so if someone pays for me...
I'll tell you who's gonna pay. Vasquez.
I don't know if he's the type
to... We can't let that prick get away with this. We need to do something.
He just killed a guy.
People around here must just die all the time if she has that light of a reaction to it.
We steal his deal. We steal his deal.
Yes! That is what I'm talking about.
What are you talking about?
Vasquez set up a deal on Pandora for a vault key.
Whoa.
That must be why he got the promotion. The only thing Hyperion cares about more than money is vault keys.
Why?
It's perfect! I mean,
because apparently they're not that hard to get because some random fucking dude got it and is selling it.
Like for $10
million
though.
More.
You have a fucking planned space station. Send people on Pandora. Like, holy shit, do you not have the resources to do this?
Done.
Oh, there you go. He just took $10 million from everything.
What I do. $10 million is chump change around here. By the time anyone notices, we'll have a vault key.
Cool. Well, looks like you boys got it all figured out. I'm gonna go eat. Alone? Call me if you don't get killed.
Whoa, hey, we need your help. We need clearance, transportation. You're a requisitions master. We need that stuff.
Yeah, maybe a loader bot or two. Things get dicey.
Look, it's one thing stealing from a bunch of poor suckers on Pandora. You're talking about stealing from Hyperion.
Okay.
We're friends. Friends help each other steal stuff. I mean, that's how it works.
I don't know if that's true.
Victor used to steal candy bars.
I don't go to Pirate Bay for Andrew.
Come on, I'll buy you the lunch I owe you when we get back.
Fine. But you're buying me lunch now and when you get back.
That's pretty cheap, considering we're buying a vault key for $10 million.
Yeah, I don't think like, the lunch is really much of an issue.
Yeah.
I'll get you guys clearance to Pandora, get you geared up, and issue you a standard Hyperion town car.
What? Standard? Really? I mean, you can't spring for premium? Seat warmers, maybe a convertible or something?
Sure, yeah, a convertible. So, just so I got this straight, you want me to get you a car to drive around Pandora that leaves you less protected, right?
Look, it just... You're gonna steal something, I figure...
Yeah, let's go see with a bicycle. We'll be fine.
Don't worry. I've got a car in mind.
You steal his car?
Yes.
Okay, great.
The one that they set up immediately has been like, why isn't my car here yet? By the way, I'm getting freaked out by the way that you pick every option I've picked. Like, pretty much exclusively. Well, you pick the exact same thing that I've done.
Because you don't understand, but you are also as sociopathic as I am.
We're the same person. No, I think it's because you suddenly get weirdly less sociopathic when you play video games.
That is absolutely
you're
not
nicer
true.
To fake
Did you watch
people.
Wolf Among Us? Because I watched Wolf Among Us, and I ripped a dude's throat out.
That is true. We make most of the same decisions in Wolf Among Us, but I don't generally kill the people.
Oh.
Well.
I guess this is what happens when you look at the sky and dig in the ground.
That's what you get for being on Pandora in any capacity. That's how it goes. I wonder if 2K Games had any hand in this game's production besides just throwing assets
at him. What the fuck? Are you kidding me? We just ran over that guy?
Yep. What? It's a death montage. Yay. I don't know if robots are allowed to drive.
Maybe? I don't know. I don't know the rules on Pandora. But I think murder's illegal, so I'm sure robots can drive.
This will be a fun copyright strike.
Oh yeah, this is actually a song. Yeah. Shit. Wow, this car has pretty good traction.
I know, right? For, that was like, a freakishly sharp turn at that speed.
Also, this car is like floating on the
it's
ground.
It's a space car that has great sand traction.
Yeah. I don't know about that.
This is just a place where everyone dies every 10 seconds. I don't know how this planet has a population.
There's one of those guys.
Hey, it's a sign signifying the same area we were in the prologue.
It's alright.
Oh!
This is a dog.
The guy hanging from his neck was the skeleton from the opening scene.
What do we even hit?
Yeah.
That's how much time's gonna pass. Holy shit. These five episodes are gonna take a while.
Crap. I think we killed it.
It's just a fucking dog, dude.
Murderers now? We're murderers. We're murderers. Only
a sag.
We murder.
Relax, Vaughn. It's a skag. They breed like hostile rabbits down here.
Still,
do hostile rabbits
kind of
breed
sad.
More or less than normal racket rabbits?
Kind of.
Rabbits of mild repute. It's not even dead. It'll be fine.
Yeah, it looks.
Or it'll get eaten by that thing.
Yeah, I'm just helping nature out.
Yeah.
Don't hate.
The circle of life.